Steelers fans, you could win a trip to Super Bowl 55 and a new 2021 F-150, the official truck of the Pittsburgh Steelers, sponsored by Neighborhood Ford Store. Rules and regulations are on the entry page, and remember, this contest is a twofer. Scroll down the page after you voted for the super fan of your choice and enter to win that truck. Visit FordHallOfFans.com/football.
All right, welcome back. We're going to go back out to the phone lines. Paul, who are we going to go with? We'll start with the Steelers here. We're going to go out to Dave from Conneaut. What's up, Dave?
I just wanted to get your guys' opinion on, the Steelers' longstanding procedure of not negotiating with these players, the fourth, fifth year guys that are having a good year during the season. And I just think we're losing a lot of them, and other teams negotiate contracts.
You know, Paul, that's always been a rule of the Steelers going back to how long ago, that they don't negotiate with players once the season starts after training camp. I don't mind it, but maybe things do change now. Maybe it is an opportunity to maybe change the way you do things just because everything is changing. We're evolving.
Well, and I think the Steelers, over the last few years, probably have to take a look at what they've been doing, because, you know, there are some things like that I would say are a little bit antiquated, that maybe does cost them in the modern NFL. I think there's a few things that they probably need to tweak, but by the same token, they've had a system. It's led to a very consistent, every single year they are, they're never terrible. They're always involved in the playoff chase and everything else. You know, to get back to elite and back to the Super Bowl, they might need to tweak some of these little things that they've done forever.
Yeah, they also need to tweak the rosters, no question about it, because right now, bringing all these guys back, all these veterans, and when you keep bringing the same people back, this is a team that, made the playoffs this year, but is not a playoff team. Hasn't been a playoff team in, since 3 years ago, and then they lost in the first round that year. I mean, maybe it is good to shake some things up right now, right?
Well, yeah, I think this group of players is probably not quite good enough. The problem that you have is a lot of these guys are veterans. If they want to come back, like if Marquise Pouncey and Ben want to come back and DeCastro comes back, and what do you do? You're going to have to figure out a way to rebuild the roster in other ways, but you're going to be salary cap strapped because you got three guys or four guys. You might have to think about doing something like cutting a guy like Joe Hayden. It's going to be interesting to see how it all fits together.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to see Joe Hayden gone, though. Let's go out to Brad and Sharon. How you doing, Brad?
I'm doing good. Just before you went off the air for a break, you mentioned slightly what I think has been the Steelers' problem for at least 2 years. They don't get consistent play from their line. When Mike Munchak left, he left a line that made two men back-to-back all-pro running backs. We can talk about replacing Ben and other draft choices, but
And they talked about how important it is, Paul, for them to find the right offensive line coach right now. And maybe they made a mistake promoting Sean Surrett, who was maybe underqualified for that job when Munchak left. Maybe they could have went out and got a better offensive line coach. That's what they definitely need to do now. And it's been a weird year with the pandemic and everything. And it did seem like, I don't know if it seemed like to you, but it seemed like David DeCastro was tuned out. That one interview that he did like halfway through, it didn't feel right. And maybe it's because we weren't there. We weren't around the players, but it just didn't feel right to me this year.
Well, and I think, it's Sean Surrett to me. Is it his fault that Zach Banner got hurt? Is it his fault that Alejandro Villanueva got old? Is it his fault that David DeCastro, like you said, mentally was checked out all year and really physically with that knee probably wasn't 100%? Is it his fault that Marquise Pouncey got old? It becomes a real easy thing to say is Mike Munchak, you bring him back, he's a miracle worker. I got news for you. You could bring him back with this group and it ain't going to get any better. You can't. What's Charles Barkley say? Father Time is undefeated.
Yeah.
And you see it all the time.
What's he doing in Denver? Not lighting the world on fire, right?
Right.
Let's go out to Kirk.
It's amazing.
Let's go out to Kirk and Harmer. How you doing, Kirk?
Hi, guys. Great show as always, man. You guys really bring up some good, interesting topics and pick my interest anyway.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah, I love it. Hey, listen, as much as I like the guy, he is admirable. He's got a lot of moxie, a lot of guts. But Mason Rudolph is not the answer, man. If you bring in this Haskins and get this Dobbs and him to go at it with each other, this Dobbs, you know, every time they put him in against that Cleveland game, he sparked that offense. This guy has always been a good competitor, fast runner, smart player, and, man, he's got a gun for an arm.
Hey,
I
Kurt,
think if you put these – yeah.
Yeah, I was going to say I appreciate the comments, and I think you're right. I mean, I'd like to see all three of those quarterbacks next year. Paul, I know that's the way you feel too. I'd like to see what they can do, all three of them. I mean, but for me, I still think Mason Rudolph is the guy. That's just my opinion. He really hasn't proven that he's a top-tier quarterback, but I think he can get the job done. I think he's the best of the group. I'm not a big fan of Haskins. I mean, he was on a bad team in Washington, but it's a low-risk signing.
Right. I mean, he's a guy that's probably going to be a practice squad guy for a while. I mean, he's probably going to be a guy that if he makes the 53-man active roster in any – or what? I guess, what, 45 is what they dress or whatever? If he makes a – if he gets a helmet, I'll be surprised. If he gets a helmet one time, in, you know, without an injury happening, I'd be surprised. Mason Rudolph, they invested a third-round pick in him. They, you know, he's shown some signs of life. I thought he played really well in that game against Cleveland. He's got 1 year left on his deal. You got to figure out what you have in him. So you make him the guy next year, and you live or die with it.
You know, Paul, it's the cheapest route, too. And that's if you're going to cut Ben or he's going to retire, that's what you need to do to save that $19 million. Because if you go out and get a quarterback, even a mediocre quarterback is going to cost you $15 million. You're not gaining anything by doing that. You're better off just keeping Ben around for one more year. So if they're not going to go with Mason Rudolph, they got to keep Ben around. All right, now to our Tri-State Office Furniture tweet of the day. And this is from P.O. Joseph's brother, Matthew Joseph, Matt Joseph 7. He said, so proud. You've worked so hard for this moment, and you deserve to enjoy it every second of it. I'm glad you get to realize your biggest dream growing up. Love you, bro. P.O. Joseph got his first NHL point tonight in his first game. Back in a couple minutes.